So today, anybody who knows how to cook and how to create some fancy food will call themselves nutritionist. She calls it a health restaurant and she calls herself a nutritionist. So I think it's very important to differentiate between a qualified person and a not qualified person. A qualified person, of course, would have studied the basics of nutrition and dietetics along with some of the other important subjects like physiology, anatomy, microbiology, biochemistry, psychology, a whole lot of other subjects are also there, food science included, right? So all of these subjects go into the undergrad studies as well as postgraduate studies. So we study for about 4 to 5 years to start practicing as a dietitian or a nutritionist. So those are the qualified ones. But the unqualified ones are probably those who just do an online course for 4 weeks or 6 weeks or maybe even 3 months. And then they start doling out advice. But unfortunately, they make much more noise on the social media than we do because we don't have the time to do all of that. We are so busy, you know, in our own work and in our profession that we don't have find the time to make noise on social media. So if you come across somebody who is promising, you know, miracles or any such thing on the social media, probably that person is not qualified because nothing can work like a miracle. No food, no single food can work like a miracle for any of the health problems, right? Because it's always a synergy that happens with several foods. And today we talk about the importance of gut health and gut microbiome. So we know, I mean, although Ayurveda said this thousands of years ago, today even modern medicine is talking about gut health and gut microbiome and gut-brain axis, gut-heart axis, and a whole lot of other things. So we know that what we eat is important, but not just what we eat and, you know, how much we eat, the quality, the quantity of food, the variety, the time of eating, all of this, circadian rhythm, everything is plays an important role. So somebody who just talks about one food being working like a miracle for everything is probably not qualified. So please question the person who claims to be a nutritionist. Question that person's credibility, question that person's qualification, question that person's experience, knowledge, whatever it may be. And then if you're convinced, and I'm sure you would do the same thing if you were to go to a physician or a doctor,